Hey guys, this is Genesis Fagan. Welcome to my YouTube channel. I am so excited. I finally made a video. I know I was always saying like, hey guys, I'm working on this video. It's gonna be posted very soon. But when I was in the midst of actually making the video, I got sick and bedridden for a whole week. But I'm not gonna go into details because it's gonna be in next week's video. The video is going to be about my modeling journey as a petite model in the industry, along with some tips and advice for you guys, because I know you guys are always DMing me like, how tall are you? You're a big inspiration for me. I'm an inspiring model as well. How do I get noticed? What agency are you signed to? What agencies are good for petite models like us? To myself, what better way to answer all these questions than a YouTube video? I started modeling when I was 16. Honestly, I didn't always knew I wanted to become a model until I wanted to model for American Apparel, because back then, 2013-14, if you were American Apparel model, you were popping. So I would go to their open castings every single time, and I'd get so upset when I didn't get a call back. I'm like, maybe I don't fit their aesthetic, or maybe I'm just not the AA type. And mom was like, you know, just keep knocking on those doors, somebody will notice you. And they hired me, which was a blessing for me because I was helping my mama with the bills, and you know, it was kind of hard for me because I was a full-time student. But along my junior senior year, I started thinking bigger. I was like, you know what, I don't just want to be an American Apparel model, I want to be bigger. I want to be legendary like Kate Moss and Naomi Campbell. I want to change the industry. Because of my height, I knew it was going to be a very difficult task, you know, because you don't see a lot of girls like me in magazines or in commercials who are 5 feet, you know, Afro Latina. You always see white, tall, skinny models. So I wanted to represent like girls like me. Around that time is when I got my first big gig, which was to model for Vogue Germany. And at first I was like, finally, my time has come, I'm going to shine. And then when I walk on set, I'm just like, oh, I'm just part of the shoot. I'm not the only model, I'm all the other models, I'm like an extra, I guess. But it was still an amazing experience. And I was thinking, like, since I'm finally on Vogue Germany, that definitely means an agency's gonna sign me. Nope. Still was getting told no because I was too short and didn't fit the requirements, or it was just not what they were looking for. 2017 was a really good year for me because, like, I was in Urban Outfitters class of 2017, and then I got flown out for the first time to LA to model for Converse, and it was just amazing because I kept booking more and more jobs, and I was just like, oh my god, finally a big agency is just gonna see all the work I've been doing, they're gonna notice me, I'm gonna get signed. Then I got an email about having a meeting with Wilhelmina, and I was so excited. I was like, oh my god, this is it guys. So I went with my best friend and my boyfriend to the meeting, and I felt really confident. I was like, you know what, I got this, it's in the bag, I'm signed already, I'm gonna be in their boards. Three four days later after the meeting, I already knew the answer, no. And I really let that meeting defined my whole career. I was just like, maybe I'm not good enough, maybe I'm just not their type, maybe it's me, maybe it's my height. Like, I know it's my height, I know they didn't sign because of my height, it couldn't be anything else but my height. And then I was just like thinking, like, maybe I was wearing the wrong outfit, maybe I was wearing the wrong shoes, maybe it was my hair, maybe asking myself like same question over and over and over and over again. Like, I was really just tearing myself down. Like, even if I was getting other jobs, I was like, I wasn't happy about it, I was being very ungrateful for everything that I had. And this was also around the same time where I was getting my credits to finish high school and graduated. So at the end, I had something to be happy about. Like, even though I didn't get signed, I graduated from high school, finally. Like, a huge weight was lifted off my shoulder. As I'm talking, I realize that I'm so thankful I had my boyfriend, my friends, and family by my side to help me realize that, you know, it doesn't end there, that I had other things going for me. I was still accomplishing bigger things in life, and my time will come. You know, what's meant for me is meant for me. No one can take that away from me, something that my mom always tells me, and I've come to accept it myself, is that God has bigger plans for me. Just because I don't get a certain casting or a campaign, that I'm not gonna get something better, that oh, you missed out, that was the last chance. Even though it's easier said than done, but staying optimistic and writing in my journal really helped me out a lot, staying grounded, like keeping up with myself, like, you know, from day to day, writing all my accomplishments, writing my goals, and just telling myself, like, what's meant for me is meant for me, no one can take that away from me. And also taking therapy has helped me out a lot, because I'm learning more and more things about myself and just boosting my self-esteem, loving myself has been very helpful. It's like my first and number one tip for you guys: know what you want and keep going at it. Don't let nobody tell you otherwise, because honestly, your mind is so powerful, and what you write is powerful too. Like, speaking into existence is powerful. Like, last year I wrote that I wanted to work with V Magazine, and crazy, not gonna believe it, but I wrote down, like, shoot for Me Magazine November 2017. Then December 2017, I literally shot with them, like, before the year ended, and I was like, what? That is crazy. So that is, like, a lesson for me to just always write out my goals and it too, like, really believe in it. And even if sometimes I doubt myself, you know, just get back up, pick yourself up, and try again and again and again and again, because someone will notice you. Just because you didn't get something doesn't mean that it stops there. That the modeling industry, it's not all about glitz and glamour. It's actually a job that you have to go really hard for, because it's also a competition. And even though, you know, you may think, like, oh, I'm not prettier than this girl, and something that I or us women of color deal with, it's like the thinking, like, oh, maybe if I was white, maybe if I was, you know, just taller, skinnier, maybe, just maybe I would have gotten a job. And it's not the truth. Asian in the modeling industry matters. It needs to matter, because we're not all just one skin tone, one height. We don't all look alike. There should be more representation for Black models, curvy models, transgender, disabled, short, you know? We all need someone to look up to in different shape, sizes, color, and gender.
Second, your highlight gotta be on point, sis. Just has to be on point. All jokes aside, support your peers. Even though, like I said, the modeling industry is competition, always show your peers support, you know? Like, she got the job that you low-key wanted, applaud her, be like, yes, girl, you are killing it. I'm here for you. Slay. The only person you're competing with is yourself. No one else but yourself. And work hard to better yourself each and every day. Don't ever slack. Just because you got one job does not mean you get to be like, oh, finally, I get to just sit back, relax, and just let everything fall, like be handed to me, like, you know, silver spoon, silver platter. No. Do not slack off. I repeat, do not slack off, because if you slack off, someone else is going to pick up the slack for you.
The lighting was very rude right now. Like I was saying, someone else will be ahead of you, and then you're gonna be upset, and you're gonna be like, damn. That said, do your research, practice posing, have lots of passion, because modeling is not just about having a pretty face. No, you gotta know what you're bringing to the table, basically. No matter what, you can't quit. You just have to keep going. Like I mentioned before, just because you get something does not mean that you're not gonna get something better. It just means that whatever you didn't get was for someone else. Very important thing is your IG account must be public. What are you doing if it's on private? How are they supposed to notice you? Like, how are you supposed to get booked? How are you supposed to get signed if they can't see what they're gonna work with? Hey, seriously, it's common sense. Your IG must be public. You gotta have personal style, you know? Not just copy and paste everything you see, every single trend, you know? You have to know what works best for your body, what you look good in, what complements your skin tone, you know? I mean, your own very, very own personal style can make you stick out from the rest. If you're trying to get signed to an agency, do your research on it. That's very important, to always do your research on anything, because this is how you'll know if it's the right agency for you, even if you don't fit the requirements. Like me, like, I'm short, and you know, that's what I always get told, like, you're pretty but you're short. So don't let that discourage you. Like, just keep working, because someday someone will say, you know what, let's take a chance on this girl, even if she doesn't fit the requirement. Like, let's just give her a chance. Part of doing your research, besides knowing what type of modeling you want to get into, like printing commercial, runway, high fashion, you want to do your research on photographers. That is very important right now, because with all the assault and rape allegations, you just want to stay away from those photographers. And I think it was Ship Model Management that posted a very long list of what photographers to stay away from. So please stay safe, because as an aspiring model, when you're trying to start out, some people can take advantage of you, and not just photographers, agencies as well. They will ask you for like money, which is a big no-no. No agency should ask you to pay them. They get the jobs for you. About signing to an agency right now, read. It's very important to always read the contracts. You know, you just want to take your time reading, because you may sign something and then you're just like, oh wait, I didn't know my contract said that. Like, I just signed because I wanted to be signed. Like, you know, I don't know. So that happens sometimes. Some people just sign contracts without reading and they don't know what they get into. Where you're headed, and no matter where you end up, always remember who your friends were since day one, because it's really matters, because there's gonna be a lot of people who are just gonna try to suck up all your shine, and you know, trying to get some clout coins as well. So just stay away from those kind of people that you can tell like who they're going to be. Like, they're going to be the people that tell you like, oh, you're never gonna make it, and then when you make it, they're like, hey girl, how are you? Oh my god, all the time no see, I'm so proud of you, I always believed in you since day one. And then you're just like, no you didn't. You actually told me I was never going to make it, yet here I am and here you are. Away from those, because they're fake as hell. And also, move in silence. Real G's move in silence like lasagna. Like, because there's like evil eyes out there, you know? You can't really know who to tell your goals to, because you never know what they might be wishing or like planning on you. Like, people really be plotting on you low key. And you can, you know, they can show support or be like, you know, giving you backhanded compliments, and then you're just like, wait, so are you my friend, or are you just here for the ride, or are you just waiting to see me fail? What is it? So just stay away from those people, because they don't bring you anything good. But also, don't be that kind of person that just wishes bad on people. Like, you know, if you don't like someone, just, you know, still applaud them, and be like, I respect what you're doing, I respect the hustle, but, you know, don't wish bad on you, concentrate on yourself, because success is the best revenge. Last but not least, your most frequently asked question, am I signed to an agency? No, but I am signed to Kitten Agency, which is an influencer kind of agency. So it's like a mother agency. It's like a small agency for social media influencers. That is all for now. Hope you guys enjoyed me rambling on about my journey to the modeling industry as a petite model. And I hope you liked it, my tips and advice. And thank you all for watching. Comment, like, subscribe, share. DM me if you have any more questions, and be on the lookout for next week's video on why I was bedridden for a whole week. Bye.